Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Odwaku, if I'm coming with you. In this channel, we're all about hair. I'm looking for sensible ways to bring out my fussy natural hair. If that interests you, please kindly subscribe to my channel. I did a big job 2 months ago. The related videos down in the description box and also in the cards. And after I did the big job, I didn't like my hair. I didn't like it for real. Seriously, I didn't like it. But as time went on, I ended up liking my hair. So with this background, I want to give an advice for those of you that are big chopped. If you did a big chop and you don't like your hair, just be patient, let it grow out a bit, and then try to restyle it. Try to watch videos on how to style TWA, and there's a very high chance that you'll find a hairstyle that will fit you when your hair has grown out a little longer. For example, what I did was that when my hair grew out a little bit, I did something like a taper cut. So if you notice, my sides are shorter than the center. I equally put a part that time and my hair has grown. But what I'm just trying to say is that if you didn't like your big chop, there's no need crying and regretting. Just give it a little time. Let it grow out a bit. And then probably do a taper cut or try doing a slick down hairstyle. And you just will fall in love with your TWA, the way I fall in love with your TWA. Like, I so much like it at the moment that I think I want to pause on my hair journey. So I'm just in between. Like, I don't know whether I should keep on cutting my hair or I should go it out. So I need to get to the level of confidence that I have. Just let it grow out a bit and then experiment with your hair. I also want to give advice. If you want to do the big chop, actually there are different kinds of big chop. There's a big chop that you're actually doing, but like gorimapa, like skin cuts. There's that type. And then there's the one that is just very short. You can still see some hair on the hair, but it's very short. And then some people also chop it, say like to half an inch kind of length, and then some people actually transition, and when they are doing the supposed big chop, they already have like 4 inches of hair or 6 inches of hair. For me, it's like a misnomer. It's just, I don't even know what to call it though. It's still called a big chop, but I'm just trying to say that there are different categories of big chop. It's like a spectra. Now, for those of you that are self-conscious about some parts of your face, the bald haircut is a no-no for you. If you're self-conscious about your forehead, do not do a skin cut. If you think your ears are too flared out or too big, then don't also do that, because when you do a skin cut, your hair is now like very bare, and then everybody begins to see all the features that you have. Like now, since I cut my hair, some people are now noticing that, oh, I have a prominent forehead. So well, for me, I see it as a sign of beauty though. But even though you're self-conscious about some parts of your head, your face, then that kind of haircut is not the best for you. In that instance, if you want to do a haircut, it's better that you have at least maybe 1 inch of hair, so that you can mask some of these supposed flaws that you think you may have. Also, if you're also maybe self-conscious about your nose, you also don't do a skin cut. Don't do it, because everything will just be, when you look at the mirror, you will just be looking at your flaws. Like, it kind of emphasizes your flaws. So these are the advantages of having maybe longer hair, because longer hair can mask some of these things. For those that have maybe their ears are their problem areas, when you do like a side part or the center part, and somehow you cover part of your ears and people don't get to see it. And if you think you have a prominent forehead, when you do bangs, this like side sweat bangs, it becomes in mask and all of that. So don't do the skin shape. Rather do a taper cut, or just don't just shave your head bare like that, because you'll be literally naked. And also, if your head shape is not, let's say, symmetrical, maybe it's kind of rugged, there are bumps and valleys, and you are very self-conscious about it, then there's no need to like go bald, like really go bald. No, still leave some hair on your head so that you can mold it like that. That's one. Another thing, so if you know you have a flat or super type, I think I do, but as my hair has grown out in a way, it's not like very obvious anymore. So when you have a little hair on your head, in a way, you can mask all those irregularities that you think you have. Because the thing about short hair is that confidence is just the major thing. If you are confident, there's nothing that another person will tell you that you will listen to seriously. For me, rocking a short hair starts with your mental state. Like, do you really like it? Because when you like it, there's nothing another person can tell you. You'll just be walking to your fly. You'll just be so confident. You'll be walking like African thing and all of that. So, thank you for coming this far. If you enjoyed the video, please like and comment down below if you would consider doing the big job and if you have other tips too for those that are considering doing the big job. Thank you for watching. See you next time. Bye.